Hi, this is Jeff Goines, and I want to share with you just three simple tips about how you can start writing on a regular basis. I have found that after talking to dozens of professional writers, published authors, friends, and people that I look up to, that the one constant, the one thing that all of these people have in common is they're daily writers. They have developed a daily writing discipline. And so for some, it's only a few hundred words. For others, it's a few thousand words a day. But every great writer that I know, without fail, writes every single day. So if you want to be a real writer, if you want to publish a book, if you want to share your words with the world, an important habit to start cultivating, and you don't have to be perfect at it, but something to begin working on is developing a daily writing discipline. And this is something that I've been doing for several years now, writing a little bit every day, and it has allowed me to publish 4 books. It's allowed me to write over 700 articles on my blog and many others for other websites and magazines. And so I can tell you that this actually works. So how do you do it? Well, I think there's 3 simple tips that'll help you develop that daily writing habit faster. The first one is to use what I call triggers. So most people that struggle with writer's block, when I talk to them, the reason that they struggle with writer's block is because they sit down and they try to do 3 things all at once when they sit down. They try to come up with an idea, they try to write the idea, and then they try to edit it and get it ready to publish. So they try to come up with an idea, actually write the idea down, and then edit it, which is a lot of stuff all to do at once. That's not writing, that's idea generation. It is writing, and then it's also editing. So it's 3 different things. And when you sit down to write, you need to just write. So in order to do that, you have to have a bucket full of ideas that when you sit down to write, you can pull out of that bucket at any time some ideas that you want to share. So what I do is, as I'm going throughout the day, I'm taking notes. And I do this on my phone. You can do this in a notebook. You can do this on your computer. You can't just do it in your brain. You need to have some place where you can capture this idea so that you can come back to it later. So that when you sit down to write, whenever it is, you have a notebook or a file or some repository of ideas that you can readily pull from. And so that's the first tip, is to use triggers. So as you're going throughout the day, you're finding things, ideas, things that inspire you, different things that will help you write something. And you're going, oh, I want to capture that and share that. And so that when you sit down, you can use these as those triggers to trigger writing inspiration. So you don't have to wait to feel inspired. You already have ideas that you can start building upon. The second tip is to write first thing in the morning. Now, I know some people are going, well, I'm not a morning person. I stay up late. I'm a night owl. I totally get that. I'm that way too. I don't really like getting up early. But what I like to do is whenever I get up, whether it's at 9 a.m. or 12 p.m. or 6 a.m., I try to write a little bit. And the point of doing that is not so that I write a ton of content necessarily because I have all this time in the world in the morning. I don't. But it's to create something that I can possibly return to later. But if I can't, I know that for the rest of the day, I've written something. And this is my goal is to write a little bit every single day. And the best way to do that is to do it first thing in the morning. Otherwise, you're going to put it off and put it off. You're going to go to bed and say, I'll do it tomorrow. And on the cycle goes. So try to write first thing in the morning, even if it's just a little bit. The third tip is to stop when you're spent. And this is a tip that I learned from an author named Stephen Pressfield, who told me, to my surprise, but I've actually come to find this is the norm, this is true for me, and this is true for many other writers and published authors, is that they don't write a lot every day. They write a little bit. Most professional writers don't write for 8 hours a day. That's exhausting. They write for maybe 2 or 3 hours, sometimes as little as an hour or 30 minutes. And what I learned from Pressfield is that when he's done working for the day, when he's written his idea, written his chapter, whatever the thing is that he sat down to do, he packs it up and calls it a day. He doesn't just completely spend every last idea that he has. He doesn't hold back necessarily. When he's writing, he's really going for it. But once he's done, he's done. And this is true for any sort of habit. You know, if you go into the gym and you just work yourself to utter exhaustion, the next day you're too sore to go back to the gym. And what we know from exercise, from eating right, it's better to do a little something every day that builds momentum over time so that you can build muscle, get stronger, create more momentum than it is to just kind of binge in a certain habit and then not return to it for another week or even a month. And the same thing is true for writing. So work hard, exert yourself, but once you're done, be done. Pack it up, say it was a good day, go home, rest, and then go back to it the next day. Don't exhaust yourself so much that you're not going to want to or be able to return to it later. So stop before you're spent. So those are the three tips. Use triggers right first thing in the morning and stop once you're spent. Don't push yourself too far. And if you follow those three tips, I guarantee you, you're going to be able to write a little bit more every day, and that habit is going to turn into something very, very powerful. I'm Jeff Goines, and I hope this video was very helpful for you. Thanks. Bye.